Open your mind. Time to discover your divine self as we navigate this holographic matrix together. Strap in, cosmic family, as we slide through this wormhole of cosmic information together in search of the truth.
The truth.
You can't handle the truth.
It's time to go inside the matrix.
Inside the matrix.
With your host, Jimmy Brent.
Okay, welcome to Inside the Matrix. My special guest today is Thomas Williams. Thomas Williams was born in Liverpool in the UK. He went through a difficult childhood with controlling structures of parents and school. And he had a background of psychic and paranormal experience. He began researching for answers at a young age, but his search for truth kicked into high gear with the advent of the internet. Researching 5 to 7 hours per day, he assembled a vast amount of knowledge on a plethora of subjects. He moved to Florida in 2002, and in 2011, after attending a conference, he realized that he had to do something with his knowledge and experiences and expand into a wider field. After being on the Cosmic Voice for a while, he decided to set up his own Facebook group and radio show called Truth, Honor, and Integrity. His words and actions truly reflect that name. The Facebook page and the radio show have grown substantially in the last few years. Thomas is currently involved in many fields that cover a wide variety of topics which are vital to the survival and pursuit of freedom for all of humanity. Thomas and all the THI family that are listening and tuning in to us either now or through the archive, welcome to the show, Thomas.
Thank you, and thanks for having me on, and I'm looking forward to it, and I hope your listeners do have an open mind, because a lot of our material, as you'll know, is kind of different to the what I would call the mainstream alt media, and I hope it resonates with people.
I think that's definitely going to be the case, and we always remind people that it's so vitally important for us to keep an open mind. We need to have the ability to consider things. We don't have to believe everything we hear, but we at least have to have the ability to consider the possibilities. Otherwise, we never grow as human beings. So many of our listeners will be totally up to speed, Thomas, with what you have to say, but there are going to be some who are not and are listening to a lot of the information that you're going to present for the first time. But right now, if you wouldn't mind, I'd like to go back in time and sequence and talk about how a lot of the control systems that we find in our world came about and who was behind them. Let's talk about the Anunnaki and the Dracos and Enki, Enlil, Marduk and these characters and the importance of what they set up and what's going on in the world today.
Well, let's go back 16,500 years. My shows have gone back 110. I will extend it to 150,000 with an up and coming show. But essentially what took place here, 16,500 years ago, there was more wars that were going on the planet, that have been started, as far back as Atlantis 150,000 years ago, and Atlantis wasn't an island, it was a craft. And it just went on from there. The second moon of three we had 110,000 years ago fell and snapped the continent on the what is now the North Pole. And then it went on and further different species coming here. And then, of course, we had the Anunnaki, and there's five Anunnaki groups. And it's an avian, two human, and two reptilian. And the Draco are one faction of them. They're not the worst that's been here by any means. The Mantid group are kind of the brains behind the Draco. And also the Abraxans, the humanoid Abraxans, which is covered in Jupiter Ascending. You know, but there was a lot of wars going on here 16,500 years ago, and we had five tribes, five of the main tribal people, and the main one was fighting with another tribe, which was the Australian New Zealand tribe, and they did a deal with the Draco for technology to win that war, but it signed us all up into martial law and a slavery system. So that's the most recent. And it wasn't until 2016, August 2016, when the peace treaty was signed off. So humans were designated to be the rulers of this planet, which is likely to be the first time in history. I'm unsure on that. But certainly now, it's a number of these species that have been playing games here are not allowed to interfere with humanity anymore. Some still do, and some got dealt with. Marduk being one of them, Anu being another. They are no longer here. And so that's the change. That's why people have heard less about the ET narrative. It's all when, we're having people come on and talk about ETs. It's all events that happened in the past. Very, the abduction thing has virtually disappeared off the internet in the last 3 to 4 years. Why? Because they're not allowed to interfere anymore. We're not allowed to interfere in their world either, you know. And there's 39 species below our feet. We're working with them to gain a better understanding of each species, because all of it has been distorted and lies have been told to every single one on every single level.
Now, it seems to me that a lot of these beings must live incredibly long lives, or certainly much longer than us, because the continuity of a lot of these plans that were set forth and a lot of these slave systems that were put in place just seems too consistent over years and years and millennia, whereas, you know, humans, having a relatively short period of life, have a difficult time, you know, trying to combat, let alone understand something like that and basically become free. So the good news is, as you're saying, they're no longer allowed, you know, to interfere, but we're seeing the remnants of the Watchers, the, you know, different groups that were put in place with the control system that are still trying to exert their control over us.
Yeah, the biggest problem is the djinns. The dark, smoky people, they're the ones that the likes of the Covens, and we'll get into them, who they are shortly. Okay. They're the ones that the likes of the Covens and the dark and light magic, neither are good, because both are using other entities to do the magic. You know, humans have a natural ability once we work on ourselves and soul develop with ourselves. We have abilities, extraordinary abilities, and yet too many have been stifled with those abilities. Some of them, people stifle themselves, staying in low vibration and not working on themselves. But there's been a lot of genetic tampering, you know, and this has gone on for thousands of years. Adam and Eve are not human. Adam and Eve was their creation. That was the Draco Anunnaki creation. After they used the Fash destroyer weapons on this planet and created deserts. We never had deserts before that weaponry. And they created the flood. That's why all the Anunnaki people, Noah, Moses, they're all part of them. They all knew. They knew what was coming. They knew there was going to be a deluge. And they knew they were going to put a substitute human with what was essentially a skin suit and try to restart humanity in their image, not ours.
So what was the intent as far as what do they need from humans? You know, we know that humans have incredible ability that most of us have not really tapped into, because like you said, we have to do the inner work, the personal work, before we even become aware of our own abilities. But what was the intent? What was the outcome, the desired outcome that these beings had for us?
Well, it was the same desired outcome for many thousands of other planets and solar systems that these entities have been doing for thousands of years. In fact, you could argue millions of years. this was a harvesting operation. And it involved harvesting everything, all resources in ground, above ground. And people have to understand that humans are resources to them. Via life force energy, souls, or food.
Yeah, and that movie that you mentioned, Jupiter Ascending, that was really a lot of truth in that.
There was some distortions, but there was basic elements in it, talking about the Abraxans and the hierarchical structure, the family disputes which went on through the generations, Cain and Abel, Alulu and Anu, the list goes on, Marduk and Anu, and there's always been this repeated progression of family disputes over regions, over planets, over solar systems, and they're thinking that they're God, which they're not.
Now, a lot of people have talked about the Lush, which is the energy that humans have and can generate through our emotional eminence. Talk about that a little bit and how that's being harvested.
Well, again, that was in it was in like vials or tubes in Jupiter Ascending. It's not always in that form. It depends on which entity is Lucian. You know, some entities go for the soul. Some entities go for the general energy that we give off. And we are the elixir of the universe, our energy. It's different from every other species, and that's why we have garnered a lot of attention from various species. And of course, it then gets passed down into and is now coming out in the alt media. You know, I was talking about it about 5 or 6 years ago about the adrenochrome.
Right.
It's the same. It's life force essence. You know, and they're harvesting these life force essence, particularly out of the children, because they haven't been poisoned as much as the adults via air, water or food, or pharmaceuticals or other types of drugs. And so that gives them the life force energy and is part of the reasoning of how they can continue to live on way past what is considered a normal lifespan.
Yeah, you see a lot of these people participating in these satanic rituals, which you're referring to, where they, in case people don't know what adrenochrome is, it's pretty disgusting. They torture young children and then take their blood, which is infused with adrenaline, and they drink it. And it's absolutely unbelievable to anybody with a soul or with a conscience or with any understanding whatsoever of morality that people can actually do this. And that's part of the problem that we have in trying to expose a lot of these things going on, is that people are incredulous. They don't want to believe that anybody is that evil, is that dark, that they would possibly do things like that, because in their world, in their mind, they would never conceive of such things.
Well, the problem is people should never apply their own models to anything or anybody else.
Right.
That's the problem, you know. Because you can't conceive it doesn't mean it's not real.
Correct.
And this is how they've got away with it for so long, because it's so far off the wall to what is considered normal, and normal is a control structure, as we know.
Sure.
What's considered normal in society, it's so far off the wall, it just renders it too incredible to be believable, and that's how they've got away with it. It's the same with the sex trafficking and the children, you know.
Mm-hmm.
22,000 children die per day from sex trafficking. 22,000 per day. You know, and thousands go missing, and people go, I can't, that's not possible. Well, I'm sorry, but it is. And it's happening on a massive scale, and people have to grow a set and accept that that is reality, because only then can we face up to the problem.
Absolutely. And taking a stand is very important, because if we don't take a stand, if humanity as a whole, as a collective consciousness, if we do not take a stand, evil is allowed to prevail in our world, and we've had enough of it. We've seen it. It's all coming out now, which is wonderful that all these things have been exposed. They've been going on forever. But now we're just beginning to grok the extent of it. And it's wonderful that this information is proliferating, because it needs to. And the human family needs to wake up. We need to see things for what they are, understand what's happened to us as a slave species, and then stand up for ourselves and not just say no, but, you know, take action to stop this type of thing happening.
Yeah, everyone has a responsibility, because if part of the problem is some people don't want to hear the truth. We know that. And the reason being is they don't want to take personal responsibility for it. Because the minute you know something is correct and don't do something, that makes you complicit.
Yes.
And therein lies the problem. And there's not enough people exhibiting personal responsibility. You know, it's okay if it happens to some child over in Iraq or in Russia or China, as long as it doesn't happen to my child. Well, we can't think in that manner.
Mm-hmm.
One child is one child. It doesn't matter what religion, color, or country they come from. One child is important, because that one child could be your child.
Yeah, and that personal responsibility goes hand in hand with expanding consciousness, because as you realize what's happening, that is this essential step. Take advantage or take responsibility for your own life and realize the things that are happening and then do something about it. I wanted to ask you, what is your estimation on how many humans are actually here in this world and how many non-humans are parading around as humans, and what are they doing?
There are two figures. One's 15% organic humans and 85% non-organic or non-humans. And a recent figure which I put out recently, which appears to be more accurate, well, I hope it is because it sounds better, is that 62% of beings here are human. There's 25% that are not human, but some are in a human skin. Marduk was in a human skin. And there's 13% of what we would call synth spots or clones.
All right. So I'm sure to some people that's going to come as a bit of a surprise, but to others of us, we it's not surprising at all. And for those who have never seen the movie They Live, from I think it was from the 80s, That's an interesting movie that there was a guy in there who discovered these sunglasses and or glasses. When he put them on, he could see beings for what they actually were. And he could see the ones that were not humans. And don't you wish we all had those glasses?
The point is we do, but we don't see. We use our eyes, but we don't see. We dismiss most, you walk down the road and most people, even if they haven't got a phone, which makes things worse, because they're all staring down at the phone, so you don't see nothing what's going on.
Right.
But if you just walk down any high street, you will see one if you look. People have no idea. There are more prevalent in certain areas. But there are ways to spot them. And once you, it's like symbology. Once you see that symbol and recognize what it is, it's like all the little squiggles for the pedophilia. Then you see it everywhere. And the eyes always give it away. The eyes are the telltale telltale sign. They give it away. And I can see, and I see a lot of them. And I've taught some people that I've met how to see as well. You know, once it becomes a pattern, it then you start to recognize it. Actually, these are not human. But do people go into a supermarket thinking, are all these human? No, they don't. Just accept it is, and that's fine. But you may find that they're not.
Well, certainly it's pretty obvious that a lot of the talking head politicians are not. And like you said, the eyes definitely give it away. And the eyes definitely give away, in my mind, to people who are totally mind controlled. And you see that sort of bug-eyed look, that crazy-eyed look in a lot of these people. And certainly a lot of the politicians out there now exhibit that crazy-eyed look. And it's a telltale sign.
Yes. The black eyes, or empty eyes, as I would call it. They say eyes are the windows to the soul. And that is correct. And if there's nothing there, it means there's nothing there. But people go, oh, that person looks odd, or that person walks funny. Perhaps look again closely.
I think so many people are struggling with cognitive dissonance, which means that the truth is so, when they encounter the truth, it's so bizarre to them. It's so intimidating because so much of their security is based on their belief system, which has been instilled in them first by their families, then by their schools, by their religions, okay, by their political persuasions, by their, you know, all types of media, instill a fake culture in the world. And so many people are their entire security of their being is involved in these belief systems. And that's what we're up against, you know, is people need to get to the point where they can be open minded and consider other things and not be threatened by what may entirely disagree with what they think and what they've been taught all their lives, because the majority of things that we're taught are just flat out lies.
Yep. Most of the things we know, we only assume.
Correct.
When you break it all down, there's a lot of things that people talk about, but it's not a fact. It's an assumption. When people analyze what they say, and it's a good test for people who are listening to the show, you make a statement and you go, where did that come from? Is that actual fact or am I just assuming it? And you'll find most things are an assumption. Culture was created for us. It's a brand that creates divide and conquer. Normal is another control structure. So they decide what is normal and what is not. And peer pressure adds to it. I know we're coming up to a break, so perhaps I'll end on that.
Yeah, for sure. We're talking with Thomas Williams today on Inside the Matrix. We're going to take a short pause right here. Stick around with us. We've got lots more to talk about, and we'll be back in just a few minutes.
You're talk.
We're pushing the ultimate frontier here.
Control must be maintained.
How far down the rabbit hole are you willing to go? This is Inside the Matrix.
Inside the Matrix.
The Matrix is a computer-generated dream world built to keep us under control in order to change the human being.
Share your thoughts by calling 702-425-9230. That's 702-425-9230. Worldwide callers, use a Skype name KCOR Radio.
It's as simple as that.
Find us on Twitter at KCOR Radio or use hashtag KCOR. Even better, join the live chat at KCORradio.com. Now, streaming the truth from somewhere along the extraterrestrial highway.
Welcome to the desert of the real.
Your ambassador to the unknown and host of Inside the Matrix,
Jimmy Brent.
All right, welcome back to Inside the Matrix with our special guest today, Thomas Williams from the Truth, Honor, and Integrity Show and Facebook page. Thomas, let's get into a lot of the financial control systems that have been around, you know, forever. But let's talk about a little bit about the history, because really what we're talking about is representative of energy. Again, it's a harvesting system. You know, financial systems do are representative of the energy of being, you know, those of us who create in this world. So let's talk about the origins of those financial control systems and how they, you know, bring us up to speed on in the today's systems.
Well, the original money system came from Orion and was implemented here, called Babylonian money magic. Now, Babylon is a title, not a fixed place, because it transferred from Babylon to London. Babby, Lon, Don. Don means borough. Baby, Lon, Don. And there has been several systems. There was the Babylon system, the Hercules system, the Prometheus system, and the recent old one that they tried to pull back out because they no longer have control of any of them, was the Annabelle system. And it, for the most modern day, it goes back to around 1100 in our time, and the Knights Templar. The Knights Templar, the Order of St. Jerusalem, were not good and were working on behalf of the Church, who were working on behalf of the cults of Ra, back to Egypt. Everything goes back to Egypt, which then goes back to India, which we'll probably have time to cover in another show. But there was a trust, and it was ran by Marduk for thousands of years. And they collected, the idea, and they've done this on several planets, is to collect all resources, and it all goes into the trust. So the first money system was the Templars on the trade routes, collecting gold and silver off the traders, and then raiding the town under the banner of Crusades and taking the gold off them. Well, they had a load of IOU pieces of paper that they would was supposed to collect their gold, except suddenly all those people died and they kept collecting the gold. And there was a load of gold in Egypt, as we know, and that's where it all goes back to. Now, the trust in and of itself has been going thousands of years and has been run by royalty, bloodline families, dragon groups, and the Draco and the parents, which we'll get into later. And the object was in more modern times, particularly around the 1400s onwards, would give pieces of paper out. Pieces of paper with numbers on that we call US dollars or pound notes are essentially IOUs. And it's the same system from a few hundred years back that the Knights Templar had. And these families and dragon groups and all the later corporations were there to collect the assets and land and the resources and souls for the trustee who is known as the king, who is Marduk.
Can you tell us who Marduk is?
And he's the grandson of Anu.
Now, let's go just real quick. Let's go back to who Anu is. And
Anu is the father of Enki and Enlil.
And these are Anunnaki.
Yeah, he is known in the Bible as the Lord Anu.
Okay,
which may upset some people, but that's the truth. I'm sorry.
In Genesis, when they refer to the gods, that's who they're referring to?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, sorry to interrupt there. I just wanted to, because a lot of people are not going to know about Anunnaki, Draco, that this is a separate race of beings.
Yeah. The term God or gods has been distorted. There is a God, one. It's not male, it's not female, it's just Source, the creator of everything. All the other names are all fake, all of it, whether that's the Greek gods, the Roman gods, the Indian gods, the Egyptian gods, and the Anunnaki. It's all fake. They chose to become Source, and then they cut humanity off from Source and replaced it with an experiment known as religion. And it was an experiment. And it's caused a lot of damage here. There was beings below our feet coming up with all kinds of fancy tech, presenting themselves as gods. Well, just because you've got fancy tech does not mean that you are God. This is a lack of thinking on our part. The term God means a higher evolved soul being. So there are seven planes of existence here. Physical, etheric, and astral, which is a trap. And then the four mental planes. If you achieve that in one lifetime, you become God. But not God as we understand it. You're not the be-all and end-all and Neo and everything rolled into one. No, it just means you are a higher evolved being. And this is where that has all become distorted. You know, even in the scriptures, it tells you, let us, who is us, when there's only one God or Source, in our image. Who is us and who is our? Well, that is them.
Yep.
You know, it's all there. You know, when people look at it with an open mind, it's all there. None of it makes any sense. You know, snakes talking to you in the garden, bushes going on fire by themselves and then talking to you. You know, it's off the wall, and yet we have a lot of people who believe in it. Well, they believe in it because they're assuming and thinking, not thinking. This is the problem.
Mm-hmm.
So that all these gods, they're all fake, all of it. There's only one, and that's Source. And humanity is being cut off connection through it, which we may be able to get into later or another show. So the trust itself was run by Marduk, and then he had a structure of people, a wheel within the wheel within the wheel within the wheel, and then another structure around it, and then nine pyramids, another structure and another layer, and then you came to the bottom 25% who were essentially the puppets, who most of alt media thinks is the cabal, and they're the main drivers. No, they're not. All the people that are discussed on the alt media are all the bottom 25% of the control structure.
Mm-hmm.
And this is, again, this is going to be new to people. I'll talk about the control structure later. So the trust was about harvesting everything. It collected everything. So say you had, we'll go back to the 1500s, 1512, I think it was, or that decade, that the trust, who were run by off-world and collecting all human resources, gave the Rothschilds $20 million in 1500 to build an empire. Now, the Rothschilds family have more Draco DNA than any other family on this planet. That's why they're seen as important. Not no more than that. And so, as the Rothschilds and the Rockefellers and the Warburgs and the bankers and these corporations collected all these resources, gold and silver, platinum, souls, you name it. It all got pledged to the trust. Every single square inch of land on this planet, above and below, is pledged or was pledged to the trust in ground resources. That's minerals that have not been mined yet. They were all pledged to the trust, and all these families who thought they were oh so special, and there's not 13 families, by the way, there's 301. they ran the bottom 25%. They kept giving the assets to Marduk and getting pieces of paper with numbers on, which have no value. It's a piece of paper. It's not supported by an asset. So even when you go back to the Knights Templar, they give, for argument's sake, 2 ounces of gold. They got a piece of paper saying you've got 2 ounces of gold, and you go on into the next town and collect 2 ounces of gold. So that, in essence, that piece of paper is backed. But we got taken off the gold standard. And so by 2007, Marduk had every single thing he wanted, all the assets. And all these so-called royal families and bloodline families and Rothschilds, Rockefellers and all them type of people all thought it belonged to them. Until Marduk decided, we have everything now and we're going into the final phase before 2012, which was to eliminate humanity and the planet. This is what they've done to several planets. And when I say several, I'm talking tens of thousands. And so from 2007 onwards, all the families all got cut off. He had everything. He spun them all a massive lie, and they all fell for it. They fell for the seducement. And it's a common human failing where we're presented with things, have some pieces of paper, go and do this, or have some technology and allow us to take over this land or this planet.
Yep.
It's a repeated failing. You know, these clowns offered Kim and I $2 billion to walk away from the trust, and we told them to go and stick it. A lot of other people would have took it and ran. You wouldn't have got far. But that's where we have to draw the line. We have to do what's better, not for me, myself and I, and what's better for us, and us being the whole planet, including the 39 species below our feet, because they've got lied to and been abused and enslaved also. Most of them are brought here to administer the martial law. Now they want to go back. So the trust after 2007 cut them all off, and that's why we had the crash 2008. And then we're having an RV, and then we're having Nasara and all Saint Germain trusts, which never ever existed. I've seen all the records of the trust, all 6,500 and something of them, and not one of them said Saint Germain. There is no Saint Germain trust. And
I would say that's a New Age hopium.
Yeah, it's a savior program. Wait, you sit back and wait for Nasara, RVs, blah, 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 or Pleiadians.
Farm programs, back. One People's Trust, Swiss Indo.
Oh, yeah, don't talk to me about Swiss Indo.
So many mind boxes.
Swiss Indo were involved in off-world child trafficking.
Unbelievable. Please continue.
So in 2007, he cut them all off, and then we all went into a recession, which we still haven't come out of, despite the clowns on the TV and these so-called financial experts telling us this is improving. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. It's all a lie. You can't base the stock market. You see a public stock market and there's a private stock market. And their private one is 7 seconds ahead of the public one.
Isn't that convenient?
Yeah. So they always win.
Of course. And that's how they can jump in and manipulate, get insider trading. I know in my own personal world, the money people that I've been exposed to on the high level, on the billionaire, well, it's actually low level, but the level that we can relate to and see on the billionaire level, it's all insider trading. That's how these people make their money. That's how they maintain their money. And they all work together and let each other know what's happening. They make the trades, just like you said, before everybody else. Yep. They get their trades in, they make their money, and it's the little guy, the little investors in the stock market who, you know, are left holding the bag.
Yep. Always the way. That's how the Rothschilds developed and took control of Britain and France back in the 1800s, so the Battle of Waterloo, I think it was. You know, Rothschilds sent a telegram telling Britain he'd lost the war. The stock market collapsed. Rothschilds and his cronies bought it all up and then sent another message, said, oh, we got it wrong, Britain won. And the stock market went through the roof, and so did Rothschild's stock go with it.
Just exactly like the stock market crash of 29. Same method.
Yeah, it's all orchestrated. Nothing is by accident. There is no accidents. There is no coincidence either. It's all designed. And the more you open your eyes and really see, it's all there. You know, they say hidden in plain sight. It's all there once you see.
It is.
You have to see the patterns. And the pattern always repeats. It's not ingenious, you know. The pattern always repeats, you know, on various levels, not just banking or political or whatever. The pattern always repeats. History repeats unless you correct it.
Absolutely. What about the symbols that are used? What is the importance of all of these symbols that we see all the time? They're used in corporate logos. We see them everywhere. And there's definitely a reason why these symbols are pushed out in front of us.
It's, to put it bluntly, it's to take the piss, to being honest. You'll find, they find it hilarious that we have no knowledge. I've been with people who have been in meetings with these where they're all sitting around laughing at our stupidity. Oh, we put this in that film right in the face, and none of them, or very few of them, noticed it. You know, you'll find a lot of the symbols are the sun ray. Why? Because that's worshipping the cult of Ra, which is where the originated in out of Egypt, but started in India and continues in the country known today, even though it's not a real country, in Israel. El means God. It's the same cult that's gone right across Europe, into America, right across the Middle East, and created havoc for thousands of years. You know, the series From Russia With Love, which is now up to part 6, covers a lot of this for people who want to learn more of that. They took over all the houses. They took over all the churches. They're all operating under the same banner, the cult of Ra, which is a harvesting entity. Ra is a title. It's not one being. And Marduk played Ra. Marduk also played Baal. Baal is a title also. Moses is a title. It's not a single person.
So what is happening, you know, when we talk about Baal and all these different entities, that it seems that these Satanists, these dark magicians, are worshiping and having these ceremonies dedicated to these beings. What are they getting out of this? And what's the object of what they're trying to do with these beings? And what do these beings do for them?
Well, the whole object is control, with the end goal of harvest and everything. That's the whole object of it. You know, the sacrifice. There's been some coverage of it in the last few years about the child sacrifice. Nowhere near have they got close to it, of the levels of it and the depth of it. And this has gone on for thousands of years, that they sacrifice children. But these entities will sacrifice anything once they've got what they wanted out of it. They have no value of life. They're that psychotic, they've lost all value of life. And if only humanity, the real humanity with true and live organic souls, and there is a difference, realize their own power, all this would go away overnight. Most of it already has. We've forgotten how powerful we are. And this is not flowering humanity up. It's an actual fact. We have more abilities than any other species. We are more creative than any other species. The essence of us is better than any other species. You could argue perhaps this vessel shouldn't have been created because it's more special than others, which then creates envy. But that's what happens, and that's the way it is. But we just got reduced and reduced and reduced and reduced and reduced. Now, with all those abilities, you cannot possibly be reduced to the levels that we're at now of slaves in a 3D meat suit unless we gave it away. It's not possible. We gave it away over time, and it's that totalitarian creep. Well, we have to creep it back where more people standing in their own power, exhibiting personal responsibility. It's sovereignty. People ask for sovereignty and yet won't be personally responsible. That's creating another system where somebody else looks after you. That's not work for us. The Draco have looked after us for the last 16,500 years. That's not worked well, has it?
No, it hasn't. And you know, all these social programs, socialism, Marxism, communism, whatever you want to call it, these isms, fascist type systems, it's all the same thing. It's all about controlling human beings.
And all those isms came from the cult of Ra.
Yep.
All of them.
If people, you know, this is what we're all endeavoring to do, is to bring this awareness to the human family, because the human consciousness, the pool of human consciousness, is what steers the events. And that's why the dark side spends so much time and energy influencing our thought patterns and our actions so that we can create the world that they want. But in fact, what we need to do is take responsibility ourselves, create the world that we want and that's beneficial for everybody. And, you know, that's kind of where we're at now with just trying to get that word out to people. Thomas, we so appreciate what you're doing. And we're going to take a short pause right here. You're listening to Inside the Matrix with Thomas Williams. We'll be back in just a few.
The Matrix with your host, Jimmy Brent.
All right, welcome back to Inside the Matrix with our special guest today, Thomas Williams. And we've been discussing some really enlightening information, and we're going to continue along that process. And right now, Thomas, tell us about the, you know, we're very familiar with the concept of the Matrix, you know, and that's what this is, the title of the show. And that's, we realize that we are in a matrix. We are in a control system here in this world. So let's get into the actual control structure.
The overall control structure was run by the Draco Anunnaki. And then they created another species many hundreds of thousands, at least 100,000 years plus ago, which we call the parents. They're like humanity 1.0. They were a lot taller than us and a lot stronger. And there was 21 parents. I'll give you the rundown at the end of where we're at with them now. So the Draco ran everything with the Mantids. The Mantids are the technological people. The Draco are just the militaristic thugs. And there was 21 parents who were on planet when the Draco were off planet, and they were designed, or told they were designed, to look after humanity, which is a lie. And some of these parents, I think the youngest was 7,500 years and the oldest was around 14,000 years old. So they have been here for the duration of what we know as martial law. And when the native tribe signed that agreement with the Draco for the Draco to run things. So the 21 parents, out of the 21, 13 of them ran a coven. These are your dark magicians, these are your watchers, these are your game players. And these are also the branders, as we would call it, where they brand corporations to fulfill this role or these people to fulfill this agenda. And so there was 13 parents at the head of each coven. Now, there could be 20 in one coven, and there could be 2,000 in another coven. There's no, we don't have the official figures, but we know that there was large groups in single covens, and there was smaller groups in other covens. So there was 8 parents who didn't have a role to run the coven. They were more special than the others. Then the 13 covens ran what we know as the Illuminati, which doesn't exist and hasn't done for over a decade. And these are then, you're getting into your bloodline families, of which there's 301, not 13. And then you're getting into, from the families, you're getting into the lower structures of what you would call the cabal. And these are then your dragon groups and various other types of names and entities. Now, what happened is the Draco, the bulk of the Draco left in 2015. They were, despite what they think, they were forced out of here altogether. There was minions left behind by Annie to carry on playing games. The parents went from 21 down to 2. None of them are in here anymore. There is a VI aspect to them, of both of them, that looks like they're here and they're not. You got to remember that the technology, there is no new technology. Technology is all the past, thousands of years ago, all of it. So they have VI representations in here. One of them is known as the Red Queen, particularly nasty Biatch. The covens where we can't decide whether there's 2 left out of the 13 or none. They are breaking apart badly, and they're losing control. The Draco lost control, the parents lost control, the covens then lost control. The families and what we knew as the Illuminati, you know, when people started some people started waking up with the Dan Brown movies and, oh, they're talking about the Illuminati, so it is real. And they're all laughing at us because the Illuminati had gone. And what it broke up into is 5 factions. The Asian faction, the Nazi faction, the Jesuit faction. And essentially, now with these 5 factions, that they are fighting for control. Now, what was left behind by the Draco was Marduk. And Marduk ran all of them with the minions, generally the Rothschilds family. Like I said, they have got more Draco DNA than any other family on this planet. So now we're left with these 5 factions. And they're not only fighting each other for control, they're infighting within their own groups. And what's playing out, and this is happening in the alt media, there's a lot of shows who are faction based, whereby they're going to tell tales on, for argument's sake, on the Nazi faction, because they want the Jesuit faction to be the leader. Or the Asians are going to expose this. Yeah, an example of this is in the British newspaper a few years ago. You know, the most of the media is run by what is called the Jewish faction, except they're not really Jewish. They're Hebrew and they're cults of Ra followers. And they've labelled the poor Jewish people under that banner and the religion. And people really need to understand that. And if you want to understand that more, go and listen to my series From Russia With Love 1 to 6. It covers everything. Don't blame the Jewish people. They've been used as pawns. And in the British newspaper, they, on the front page, they put the Queen is a Nazi. And a photograph of the Queen doing the Nazi hand signal. Why would a British newspaper do that? That is faction fighting. And yes, it's disclosure. They're going to, you know, the Jewish faction are going to expose the Nazis and the Jesuits for what they've done. We're getting disclosure, but these groups are missing out what their group's done. And this is what people are missing a lot on the alt media, is there's a number of shows that are faction based. They're employed by their faction or agency to put out a load of information. Like I said, it's all disclosure, but they're missing one portion out. And people should understand that when they're listening to certain shows. Why are they leaving one particular group out? So, you know, you've got your Asian, Jesuit, Nazi, the Jewish, Hebrew, and also the secret society. They're your five factions. And they're all taking each other out. This is why Hillary Clinton is now being thrown under the bus.
What's her faction?
She operates under the Blue Dragon Group out of the UK. She's the head of the Blue Dragon Group out of the UK under the banner of GCHQ, MI5, NSA and CIA. But she's danced with the Jewish, but also danced with the Jesuits, but is working directly for the Rothschilds. The Rothschilds, for their part, control all five factions, so they win, which then means it then goes back to the Draco, with them having more Draco DNA than anybody else. The Rothschilds bet on all horses, so they win, and they'll play them all off on each other, so they collect. It's like wars, you know. The bankers fund both sides.
Yep.
You know, George Schiff, known as George Herbert Walker Bush, real name Schiff, funded both sides.
Yep.
They were the Nazi faction. They were the paperclip crew. But there was Nazis here way before the paperclip crew. That's the illusion. That's the sleight of hand. The Nazis were here in the 1800s.
Yeah, and we've got a lot of them over here now, thanks to Operation Paperclip.
Yep, there was 250,000 flights between 1946 and 1948, bringing stuff out of Germany. U.S. military. Imagine the cost of that to the American people.
Oh, yeah. What about the Vril? What about the Vril? How do they fit in?
Well, the Vril girls were part of what is known as... let me think now. The Looking Glass. They were in part of the Looking Glass technology. And they would get together, and if most of them agreed on a certain outcome, generally that outcome took place. Now, they got snatched around 1945. They're still alive and are being held hostage by the SSP.
Mm-hmm.
Except their Looking Glass technology failed in 2012, which was the end date of not only the trust for their control of it, but the trust has been taken over by humans now. but 2012 was the extinction level event ending. That's why there was a lot of fuss over 2012. They wanted to get rid of humanity by that date and failed.
What was their main process that they were going to use to basically wipe the slate clean?
Well, they have all kinds of technology. They've used it in the past, the Fash Destroyer. It's essentially like a weapon that rolls like a tsunami on water or land and just destroys everything in its path once it's set off. Like I said, that's how we ended up with deserts here. We never had deserts. They're all damage caused by the Fash weapon.
No, but say that again. Maybe you could spell it because I'm not sure if I caught that right.
Fash, F-A-S-H.
Oh, okay.
That's what caused the damage 110,000 years ago when the continent of the Aria, which was northern Russia, collapsed into the ocean. That's where you get the story of Atlantis, the continent collapsing. Now, that was the Aria, D-A-A-R-Y-A. And that was 110,000 years ago when they hit the second moon, Fata, and it fell in chunks and was hitting the Earth.
So where does CERN fit into all that? What are they trying to accomplish with CERN?
No, it failed. It's another one of their projects. Everything they have tried has failed. And one day they'll realize that no matter what they do, it will fail. That we're not on the same timeline. They just haven't. They're just not clever enough to work that out yet. So CERN was about creating a portal to the galactic central sun when it was in a certain alignment, and that got ended in August of 2015. They can fire it back up again, but it won't work for the purpose that they'd set out for. And now it's too late anyway.
That's good news. All right. So let's talk about the World Mana Holding Trust. Can you give us some history? You kind of touched on it a bit. Let's bring us up to current with the trust.
Well, Kim was approached. Kim worked, who is the trustee now. There's only one trustee. Like there was only one trustee previous, which was Marduk. Kim worked in banking, high-level banking. She was doing gold deals on behalf of governments and visiting various countries around the world, including Russia, which is where she met Marduk and Putin. And that's where she saw some of the behavior of Marduk, who thought it was also funny to take the piss out of the humans. At that point, she didn't realize that he wasn't. It was all a bit woo-woo to her at the time. But she learns very, very quickly. And during that meeting in 2010, Kim was asked to do a test of her DNA, and it fitted what was required, somewhere in the region of 99% of source-based DNA. She's not the only one who has, we all have source-based DNA, but it's just in reduced volumes because of the amount of reduction gone on with the genetics here. So in essence, Kim is related to most, if not all, living souls here in some way. This was a complete shock to her. What are you talking about? Arnie came here to do a gold deal on behalf of the US government.
Surprise!
And suddenly, Putin's in, and there was a meeting with Marduk and Putin. And Putin asked at that meeting, and I think it's important for people to understand, when is the RV happening to Marduk? And he says, it's never happening. That was just a ruse to keep them waiting. Mm-hmm. You know, this is why, you know, I've been telling people that the RV's not going to happen. It's not. It's not possible. So that's how then Kim got pushed into this position of trustee, because it, the agreement was expiring in September 2012, somewhere around there. And then Kim got pushed into this position, and then she started realizing this is not what I thought it was.
And, now, with Marduk, would we know his name? Did he go by another name? Would we recognize him as, or he's totally behind the scenes?
Everyone knew him as M, and most people think he was human, but he's not.
Okay. Go ahead.
You know, it was him that set up the IBM. IBM. IB Marduk. That's where that name came from.
That's great.
You know, and so Kim got pushed into this role, and then she's looking through all these accounts and completely horrified at the numbers of zeros that are all over the planet in all these trusts, and thinking, why are we short of anything? You know, and then she kind of went along doing things, trying to make sense of what is this quantum system, and also the work with the trust and what it entails. And then she heard the show that Shane LaRuna and I did. And, yes, of course, she had the control system document, but couldn't make sense of it. Now, there's some things that are obvious, like the bottom 1% are the U.S. military and politicians. That's how far down they are. And then you've got Bilderbergers and all those Club of Rome, and everyone thinks they're so important. They're about 15% from the bottom. And so there's things you can recognize, but the wheel within the wheel within the wheel, which is the inner control structure, she had to work on. And then some of the information that Shane, mainly Shane, and I put forward in that particular show back in 2015, I think it was.
I remember
She started making sense of what's the wheel within the wheel. And then I did the show just after it about the factions, which caused a lot of ructions, because that show told you there and then there is no Illuminati. Well, that freaks them out, you see, because they're talking about Illuminati and getting people involved on an energy path, believing in the Illuminati when it doesn't exist. So then you miss the sleight of hand. They use that so many times.
Misdirection. Yeah.
And sadly, we fall for it too many times, you know. And so Kim then contacted me in February of 16, explained what the trust was, and we spent near 30 hours on calls over a long weekend, you know, because I wasn't sure. Because, and you know, we've had all these NASADAs and JISADAs and birth certificates and RVs and Sims and dings and dongs and all that rubbish, and nothing ever came to fruition, and neither did I expect it to either, you know. And so this was technically, when I went into it, was another money program, and so I was very wary that I wasn't going to add to that list. And then very quickly I realized this is not about the money. And people who think Manor World Holding Trust is about the money are ignorant of what we've been saying. It's not about the money. Essentially what the trust is doing, because it, all the assets got pledged by the families and all the other harvesters, as we call them, Kim decided, once she found out all the corruption and the system, that she wanted to give it all back to humanity and share it between the countries, because there's lots of assets in there for each country that were pledged that shouldn't have been done. and loans and all kinds of other stuff that were interest-bearing, that belongs to the country. And we want to get all that back. But what's going back is life force energy. And people will represent it as pieces of paper with numbers on because they don't understand the power and the most precious thing on this planet, or the universe for that matter, is our own life force energy. That's what's returning. The work that the trust has done, and Kim and I, is about stopping the harvesting system, which is represented as money, stalling it, and then reversing it back.
This is literally the emancipation of human beings that you're talking about, all of human beings.
Yeah, and in some cases, souls. There are souls connected inside the trust. They were pledged.
And this is why I am so excited about what's going on with your group and others here. This is all of our intent to free humanity. This is what we're all about, ultimately. So right now, we're going to take a short pause. Once again, we're here with Thomas Williams. You're listening to Inside the Matrix.
You're listening to Inside the Matrix.
Inside the Matrix with Jimmy Brent.
Broadcasting to you live from the neon capital of the world.
It's everywhere.
Join the movement now by calling our hotline number at 702-425-9230.
Give us a hot spoonful of your opinion.
That's 702-425-9230.
Wow!
Worldwide callers, find us on Skype at KCOR Radio.
What's on your mind today?
It's time to change your programming and escape the Matrix.
What is real? How do you define real? If you're talking about what you can feel, what you can smell, what you can taste and see, then real is simply electrical signals interpreted by your brain.
Back with more of the truth.
After this. After this.
Thousand years ago, the world started its descent into the Dark Ages. History, as we know it, is about to be rewritten. In The Emissary, a thrilling new reincarnation fantasy adventure by Tamara Veitch and Rennie DeFazio. Ancient mysteries, an epic love story, and the timeless struggle of good versus evil unfold. In The Emissary, available now on Amazon.com. Once you pick it up, you won't want to put it down.
We interrupt this program to annoy you and make things generally irritating.
At the end of the day, we turn the lights down in the KCOR studio.
Oh, sweet.
And crank up the hottest club songs from around the world.
This is the future.
The Grind, mixed by Tina Marie, your Vegas vixen of the high desert.
What about the body? What kind of body?
Good body. Nice body.
Every night from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. Pacific. The best 3 hours of commercial-free music.
New music first.
It's time to stand up and dance your ass off. The Grind, nightly and exclusively on the KCOR Digital Radio Network.
Come on, it's kind of hot.
KCOR Digital Radio Network.
I love the way it sounds.
Love the music.
I listen all day.
The future of radio is here and now.
The only.
Friday night, 9 p.m. Pacific. Jump onto the celestial highway and travel at the speed of light. Into hyperspace.
Hyperspace.
Hyperspace. Hyperspace. Hosted by Solaris Blue Raven. She navigates you through the cosmic tides of mysticism into the world of covert technology, UFOs, mystical sciences, and the world of unforeseen forces.
You get to really sort of enjoy a bizarre ride.
Listen live, Friday night, 9 p.m. Pacific.
For Hyperspace.
The one show that blows the whistle off our government black ops projects. Hyperspace. Hosted by Solaris Blue Raven.
Solaris Blue Raven.
Exclusively on the KCOR Digital Radio Network.
Wanna take a ride?
Take a ride.
Take a ride.
If ever a breed was affectionate to a fault, it's the Golden Retriever. They're people dogs, pure and simple. And the Golden Retriever Rescue of Southern Nevada needs your help. If you would like to volunteer, foster, adopt, or donate, go to the Golden Retriever Rescue of Southern Nevada's website at grrsn.org. That's grrsn.org. Or call 598-GOLD. That's 598-G-O-L-D.
We're pushing the ultimate frontier here.
Control must be maintained.
How far down the rabbit hole are you willing to go? This is Inside the Matrix.
Inside the Matrix.
The Matrix is a computer-generated dream world built to keep us under control in order to change the human being.
Share your thoughts by calling 702-425-9230. That's 702-425-9230. Worldwide callers, use a Skype name, KCOR Radio.
It's as simple as that.
Find us on Twitter at KCOR Radio or use hashtag KCOR. Even better, join the live chat at KCORradio.com. Now, streaming the truth from somewhere along the extraterrestrial highway.
Welcome to the desert of the real.
Your ambassador to the unknown and host of Inside the Matrix,
Jimmy Brent. All right, welcome once again back to the show, Inside the Matrix, with our guest, Thomas Williams. You know, when I talk to people, a lot of times I realize that the focus of their world is very narrow. It basically encompasses, you know, their job, their family, their local community, a little bit of what they see, you know, on the program propaganda medias. But for many people, it stops there. They don't really have a consciousness or an awareness of the bigger picture, you know, of what's really going on. In order to understand a lot of what we're talking about, you have to realize that you have to look at things from a almost a cosmic level. I mean, a very level that encompasses all of what's happening in this world, don't you think?
Yeah, well, there's too many who live in what we call bubble world. I touched on it earlier. You know, people die in Iraq because people who I call cowards are dropping bombs from 30,000 feet on them. You know, it's cowardly war, in my opinion. Doesn't matter which country is doing it, it's wrong. And none of it is valid whatsoever. It's all part of the control system, which is collapsing in and of itself. But people live in a bubble world that as long as their family and their child is okay, it doesn't matter what goes on elsewhere. You know, the woman over, the old lady over the road, the house gets foreclosed on. Do people take any interest? No. We could have stopped foreclosures years ago. All it needed in America, we do have militia, is a few militia and a load of people in the community going, you're not taking this house. And that could have, you know, generated, you know, the minute you get a crowd anywhere, it generates an interest and you can pull more people in. But we didn't until it came to the time when you lost your house, then all hell breaks loose. Well, someone's going to have to do something about this. Well, why didn't you do something when it happened to the person over the road or the person in the next street or the next town or the next county? This is the way we have to think going forward. We're not individuals. We're a collective. The reason the control system worked against us is they worked together. They didn't agree on everything, but they worked together with a common goal. And you have to admire them in a way, is that they stuck to the plan. We don't agree with the plan. No, don't get me wrong, but they stuck to the plan. We have to formulate our own plan of caring and sharing for all people, including the beings under our feet, because most of them were brought here as slaves. And we have an opportunity now with the control system collapsing by the second to develop a culture, a real culture of, in our image, not the one they've branded for us, of community and collectiveness, not only with humans, but with the other species as well. So when those other species go back to their home world, they're not thinking that these humans are all savages or they're only interested in fancy bits of tech. You know, and we're not thinking that the greys, the small ones and the tall ones are here just to shove butt probes up our backsides, you know, or drill through eyes or take ovaries out or remove children. You know, there's all kinds of programs that's been run. And so we have an opportunity, but the first thing before we have any sort of mainstream ET contact is we have to learn to get on with each other. You know, we're hating Muslims in America because the media told us so. We're hating Russians because the media told us so. Have you met a Russian that's nasty? Because if not, why are you hating on them? Why are you hating on the Chinese? And it's not just Americans either. You know, it's a collective. And so we have to learn to engage each other first before we start engaging other species. Because the first thing that will happen is they're illegals. You know, we have it in America. You know, this is where people need to think. There are no illegals on this planet. How can you be illegal on your own planet? That's
right.
Cloud thinking.
Yes, it's all thinking in boxes. And of course, the propaganda out there is getting us all to fight amongst ourselves so that we never come together in unity, as you're saying, to stand up for ourselves and literally free ourselves from all these different harvesting slave systems. One thing that really has gotten to me when I realized the system of order followers that we have, the police and the military, for the most part, and people get really upset when I say that, but I want to put out there first and foremost, I understand that these men and women, their intent is for the most part honorable. Most of them are wanting to do something that they consider to be the right thing or something that they have been told is morally correct. But what happens is that they are programmed into following orders without question. And therein lies the problem, because without a strong moral compass of what is right and wrong and just blindly following orders, this is what has maintained these slave systems. Is literally, we have our slave masters have been us. And a lot of this is the police and the military, and they need to understand that, you know, you can't just follow any orders. If somebody just says, well, shoot this guy because, look, he's protesting and he's doing this, or, you know, he's going against the system. Well, maybe the system needs to be gone against. And until we develop a high standard of morality in all of us, we're going to have these problems, and we're going to be, you know, subject to these types of programmings that divide us and that enable people to be mind controlled to the point where they will just blindly follow orders. We've got to get beyond that.
Yeah. We, the people, create the control system for them.
Yep.
We police ourselves, interfering in other people's lives instead of helping other people in their lives.
Empire building.
Yeah. Competing over best house, best car, best handbag, best shoes, and best hairdo, and all the other rubbish. All external. None of it's internal, which is your real value, which is actually where your God is, inside of you. It's inside of us all. We're a part of the source, a spark of the source. It's, you know, everything else is outside of you. That's the illusion. No, everything is internal. We have people on the internet saying the healing machines are coming from another bloodline family, the Rands. You are the healing machine, and people have forgotten that. You don't need technology. It's like I mentioned yesterday, you know, calculators to add up. You've got a calculator in your head. Use it. Do we need health machines? Not really. To the ones that don't want to work on themselves and disbelieve themselves that they have no power, little me, and what can I do? I'm just one person. What about the others? Well, if everyone gets together, it's not one person, is it? You know, the ripple in the pond becomes the tsunami. But everyone on this planet, the organic human souls, has the ability to heal themselves and to heal other people. We have to start remembering. And the only way we do that is we get into addressing the self. Not what's external, what people think of us, that we have nice shoes and nice cars and I've got 50,000 likes on Facebook. It's all external nonsense. Your real value is what's inside of you. And when you do your inner and shadow work, get rid of all the traumas, get rid of all the low vibrational thinking, likes of anger and backbiting and fighting and arguing with people. They're all low vibration. Comparing yourself to others. Competitive mindset. All low vibration to keep us in the divide and conquer program. Once you start being a loving person, unconditional, caring and sharing, these are all values of the higher soul development that takes you out of the astral trap, which is the holographic matrix, not the planet, onto the mental planes. All your junk DNA that they tell you you have, that junk DNA is where all your abilities are, your healing, telekinesis, biolocation, you name it. We don't need tin cans to travel the stars. We have our own vessel to do so. And this is where the trust comes in and the work that's going on around it. The core aspect to me is we have to reteach the whole planet, not only every single profession, because all of it's done wrong, because no one's being trained the right way. But we have to teach people how to be human again. And we have to go back to the basics, because we don't care enough. We don't have enough people with empathy, because people with empathy wouldn't show a lack of care to others. They wouldn't be punching somebody else, because empaths, when an empath hits another, they feel it. We would have empaths who are doctors and nurses. How can a doctor and nurse know how that patient feels if they're not empathic?
That's right. And vaccines and this whole autism spectrum makes people that are not in touch with their humanness and their feelings and their empathy.
We've allowed ourselves to become what they created for us, savages. We've been in a devolution program. And we have to step out of that, recognize what we failed as a collective, and reboot it, reset it. But not everyone will make it. Not everyone will make it. Not everyone's ready. But it's up to you, the individual, to push yourself, take your time for yourself, love yourself. Not enough people actually love themselves. Very few people actually trust themselves. So how can you trust in the fact that you are attempting to heal yourself if you don't trust yourself? Lots of people won't trust their own intuition. You keep getting these little messages in your head and you keep ignoring them and going, oh, that was a coincidence, or oh, that must have been deja vu. No, no, stop doing that. Recognize who you are. Stand in your own sovereignty. Support people. Be responsible for yourself and those around you. And if people don't like you, tough. That's their problem, not yours.
Absolutely.
As long as you like you, that's all that matters. other people's opinions don't really matter unless it's helpful or beneficial to you. But I know we're getting near the end. The Draco have gone down. The parents have gone down. The covens have gone down or going down or minimal. The demons that were trapped here for 3,000 years ended in December last year. The Illuminati, the bloodline families, the factions are all collapsed or collapsing. The banking system that harvests everything off us and all the resources has been collapsed by the trust and the people who work with it. Politics is collapsing. It looks and acts like a joke, which is what it is. It's a clown circus. He said, she said, mass arrests, investigations, and round we go. Russian collusion will become Chinese collusion or Muslim collusion next. And let's have another two-year investigation. Meanwhile, the country is collapsing. And it is. We have the solutions. We've provided Mr. Trump with several solutions on how to fix the IRS, how to stop the money being sieved out of the country, how to return all the military hardware that the US military sold to the Chinese faction. Every single plane is owned by this Chinese consortium, which is backed by the Rothschilds. We've tried to do a deal for that so that the US military is no longer US military, because US is nothing to do with America. It's a European control structure run by the house, all the houses in Europe, and the Rothschilds and the Bavaria and the Habsburgs and all those clans. Mm-hmm. And that the military returns to being American, not the United States. The United States was formed in Europe.
It's a corporation.
In Vienna in 1815. The Congress of Vienna, you can all go and look it up. We are not the United States. We never were. And so, you know, we worked out a whole new tax structure where the trust would support, and we have kept the American government going since March of last year. Otherwise, that shutdown would have been going on for near 18 months now. But we've run out of patience because we keep doing all this work for free and they keep promising they're going to do this, that and the other, and nothing comes back. So now we're sitting back and watching it unfold. They will have to come back to us because they've got no assets, they've got no wealth, and they've got no banking system left. They have no choice.
Well, it's a very positive thing to know that all of these control systems are going down, because it's about time. And, you know, we all just have to step up and keep the pressure on. We need to keep talking about these things, exposing, you know, all the shenanigans that have been going on and many who are continuing that whole process. And eventually humans need to get to the point where we don't even need money. We actually just cooperate and help each other to provide all that we need. And we're not there yet. We're quite a ways from that. So until that time, we still have to deal with money and things like that. But
there's 489 aspects of life that are designated to be fixed. And it's going to take 40 years.
Yeah.
You know, and that can be cut, providing people step in. You know, not sit there waiting for RV payouts or even the trust payouts. There's plenty of things people can do to end the control system, like stop buying at Amazon. You know, why are you doing that? That's the multi-billionaire club. They're the new structure, or what they're trying to do is a new structure that's eliminating all the families and the millionaires club and going into a multi-billionaires club with the cryptocurrency.
And
people think you're getting around the system with that. That was created by Langley and the NSA. You're living in cloud cuckoo land.
The cryptos are actually worse than the fiat money system we have now. I mean, it
boggles my mind. You give what you know what is fake money, because a U.S. note is fake money. It's a debt instrument, but it's currently classed as value, and you get fresh air tokens. I've never heard anything so ridiculous in all my life, and it's getting around the system. No, it's not. No, it's not. Not when it's created by the same clowns. You know, the IMF told everyone, 134 countries last November were scrapping currencies, so that means there is no RV, because that was a revaluation of the currencies, which was never going to happen. And we're going with crypto. Why? Because they no longer control the currencies or no longer control the banks. And decentralization is shutting down all the central banks and all the middle banks, where they have everything on a cloud, in a phone or a computer.
Where and the people have no control over any of that.
None. And if they don't like you, they'll just go press delete. And what can you do? Go searching for fresh air tokens? Really? Good luck with that.
Yeah, we can't let that happen. We can't let that happen.
They won't do that. Well, you tell that to the people who used to smoke in bars or the sports stadiums 20 years ago that they were banning. They did. You tell that back to 1920 when they banned alcohol. In 1910, they would have laughed at you. In 1920, they did it. You tell that to the people in 1930 who had gold and silver, that the government had taken it all off them and make it a criminal offence. They did it. And the income tax, which is not legal. Oh, it's only a temporary measure. And here we are, what, 90 years later. 90 years is a long temporary for me.
Yeah, and it's voluntary.
They did it. Yeah, they did it. So don't make the excuse, oh, that won't happen, because that means you're just going to sit there and watch it and not participate and go, I'll tell you what's not going to happen, is I'm not going to allow it. And the more of us that say we're not allowing it, they can't handle a number of humans together. They just can't handle it, even less so now. We're saying, no, we're not having it. We're not having GMOs. What happened? 33 countries banned it. We're not having chemtrails. That's now gone. In fact, for the last 4 years, we've been immune to chemtrails, which is something new for some people. And yet some people go, oh, we're all going to die. And 5G is the latest distraction. We're all going to die. 5G is no worse than 4G. And all it is a faster platform to create more fresh air tokens. That's all it's about. You know, and we have to get smart. We really have to get smart. We are the problem. You know, you want mass arrests. Fine. Let's sack all the American politicians. What happens next? That's the question. And you get crickets. And that's what has to change. People have to future think. And by that, I mean, if you take an action, what are the consequences? What are the pros and cons? What is the solution? That's how people have to think going forward. And that's what we're working with the trust and setting up the THR groups, where everyone has a say. Not a select few again, not Kim, not I. Everyone. You want to change the world, a different world. It's up to you to change it. Not
Thomas,
Kim.
Tell everybody me. Tell everybody where we can find you and the THI groups.
Truth Honor, just type in Truth Honor and Integrity. You'll find the Facebook group, the MeWe group, the Spreaker show, the YouTube channel. It's all there. Just type in Truth Honor and Integrity.
Very good. A special shout out to all the THI people out there, because I know at least a few of them reached out to me, and I really appreciate that. Thank you very much. Thomas, it's been a pleasure having you on the show. Thank you so much for sharing your wisdom with us today. And I look forward to having you come back very soon.
Yes, I look forward to it. And I hope your listeners got much out of it.
Yes, it was really good. Thank you so much. Until next time, next week, everybody, take care, love one another, take care of yourselves, and we'll see you next week.
This is Inside the Matrix, hosted by Jimmy Brent.
Are we done?